Hello, you multi-master vloggers. Yes, thank you, Stefan, for your malt mention, which introduces Whisky Review 275B, Identifying Fake Whiskies. And this follows on from previous vlogs, 274 and 275A, in which I've introduced you to buying whiskies at auctions. And it can be a lot of fun, but there are hazards, and the main hazards are fake whiskies. Now we'll start with this one, this little fella here, which I bought at auction and which I believe is fake. I'm not too bothered about it because it was part of a group of whiskies, and it was other whiskies that I was actually wanting to buy, not this one. It's Slant Bay 12-year-old Scotch whiskey. Aye. Now why, in my opinion, well, is this a fake? Oops, excuse me, I dropped the top. First of all, you won't see it very clearly, but 12-year-old blended Scotch whisky. It has a rather low neck fill. Because it's a dark brown bottle, I'll use my finger to indicate where the whisky actually goes to. It's about two-thirds way up the bottle. Now, the reason for this becomes more evident when you look at the top. Now, what you have is a broken stopper. Now, it's cork. Many whiskey bottle stoppers are cork. But I don't believe that the original stopper's been broken off and left in the box, because there's the stopper that came with it. And I'll tell you why. Look at the colour of the cork. They're different colours. Importantly, when you actually superimpose the lid over the cork underneath, the breaks don't sit flush. They don't correspond. This, in my opinion, is a different stopper which has been deliberately broken up to make it look like it came off this bottle of whiskey. The stopper is the wrong type with its plastic and perforations for this period of whiskey as well. It looks remarkably new and fresh. It looks like it came off a cheap bottle of sherry. I'm not too bothered though, because it didn't cost much and it gave me an excellent model to show you a standard fake whiskey. Now, whether the whiskey inside this bottle is genuine or not, and I do believe they just simply stuck a broken up wine cork into this bottle. In fact, you can see a little hole where the corkscrew went into the cork. It doesn't bother me too much. It's more of a curiosity more than anything else, but it demonstrates how easy it is and what simple devices people will use to fake a bottle of whiskey. Now, there are, with the more expensive whiskies, there's a fundamental weakness which allows fakers to fake. And even as I'm speaking to you here now in 2012, there are people buying empty bottles of old valuable single malt online on eBay. Brora bottles, Port Ellen bottles, empty. There are people going round hotels and bars in the UK who are asking at the back door if they've got any old whiskey bottles, you know, the good ones, and they're passing over a few pounds to the barman to give them empty bottles of Talisker, Port Ellen, Macallan. This is big business. Mark my words, there's far more fakes out there than people realise. And you have to be very, very wary when you're buying. Also, the auctioneers have to be very, very wary when they're selling, because if an auction house, wherever it may be, gets an ongoing reputation of selling tampered or fake whiskies. People are going to get vocal about it online. It's a sign of the times. So there we are. First fake. Second one. Ardbeg. Thing about Ardbeg. And, oh, there we go. It actually happens when people take a bottle of whiskey, Ardbeg in particular, out the box, the foil lid will come off in their hands. You've got to grip the bottle firmly. Now here's a bottle I bought, which when I opened it up, you could clearly see that the foil is not flush and tight against the bottle itself. Now what I've done here is I have taken it to the Isle of Man, because I live in the Isle of Man. Here we are, I've got the paperwork here. Department of the Environment. And I had it analysed for alcoholic strength, because when people are faking whiskey, they don't tend to put stronger whiskey into the bottle. They would tend to use weaker whiskey. So it doesn't cost you too much, about £10 or so, to go to your local environmental department and get their scientific officer to analyse the specific alcoholic strength, which in this case is, instead of 54.2%, it is 54.4% alcohol, which actually suggests that this, although the stoppers come off, it may well be authentic and genuine Ardbeg Ugadal that's actually in the bottle. But I still have doubt in my mind. Certainly the labels correspond correctly. The bottle is correct. But, funnily, I have actually had someone offer to do more detailed analysis, so we'll see if there's anything being added to it, because at the back of your mind there must be, has someone gone and put some speed or LSD or something, into the whiskey just for a lark? You know, that does cross one's mind. Although it's also good not to get too paranoid about it. But one of the problems with Ardbeg, and Ardbeg stands out with this, is the fundamental, in my opinion, and it is my opinion, the fundamental insecurity of the foil seal. It's just not suitable for purpose, in my opinion. Right. Now take Macallan. Macallan have now taken steps to improve the security of the seal of their bottle. And what they've done is they've put a hologram stamp at the base of the seal, so it is more difficult for fakers to forge it and for fakers to interfere with the seal on the bottle. And I commend Edrington for doing that. However, I think that bottles like this, to commemorate the marriage of Prince William and Catherine, Duchess of Cornwall, Cambridge, sorry, got to get these things right. This is a seriously collectible whiskey, and because of that, the manufacturers recognising the longer term reputation depends on improving security at a time when fakers are getting more and more clever. What I would like to suggest is that distillers take a leaf out of Duncan Taylor's book. Now here's a fine old 26-year-old Glenesque, rare single malt. Oh, I'm looking forward to opening this bottle. And it's got my tasting notes from when I had a sample at a whiskey festival there as well. But what Duncan Taylor have done, if they've put a very glued paper seal, ornamental paper seal, round the base of the metal seal to further increase the security of this bottle and decrease the effectiveness of tampering with it. So I would suggest to all distillers who are taking their collector's market seriously, it's just an opinion, just a suggestion, Start improving the security of your seals even further than they already are. Some, like this Ardbeg, in my opinion, are simply inadequate and will seriously impact on future collectability of Ardbeg. That's an opinion. But here with Duncan Taylor, a proper paper seal, it could be plastic, it could be fabric seal with a hologram in it, would certainly address that problem. Now, considering the millions upon millions of pounds that distillers spend in marketing, it's not going to cost an awful lot of money to actually address security problems.
Right.
It doesn't matter whether it's the 10-year-old Ardbeg or the single cask 1970s. It is simply too easy to remove this flimsy seal. Finally, we're going back to Port Ellen. I mentioned this Port Ellen 5th edition, didn't I, in my last whisky review, 275A. This, my merry maltsters, is a fake. It's not Port Ellen. It's standard blended whisky. Now, even the experienced amongst you would be fooled by that. The bottle's right, the carton's right, it's simply been recycled. All I've done is put a standard generic homemade wine shrink seal over the top. It shouldn't be black, it should be metallic silver. Check your bottles carefully, because that, to the casual eye, looks completely authentic, and it's not. Considering the amount of money involved, it's a lot of heartache when disappointment kicks in. There is help at hand, by the way. Oh dear. Won't be a minute. www.whiskyfun.com/war. Warren Fakes. It's been pioneered by the Malt Maniacs. It's an increasing inventory of details and anecdotes on whiskies that are fakes, potentially fakes, and very important for us all, how to spot and identify these fakes. The bottom line is, if in doubt, just don't buy. So I hope you found this useful, because I'm here to help at Ralphie.com. Here we are, Ralphie.com. And in the next review, 276, I'll be on location at Mulberry Bank Auction House in Glasgow, where they recently had a whisky auction and they'll be having some more. And I had a little chat with Angus McRaild, who is their whisky specialist. Interesting chap, very articulate, fiercely intelligent, and he knows his stuff. And we had a very interesting conversation, which we will be sharing with you. Tune in, Malt Mates, and find out more soon.